Your body is very sensitive to a buildup of CO2. If CO2 increases by 2 to 5 millimeters of mercury, ventilation doubles. Now, during physical exercise, your body produces carbon dioxide. The more you move your muscles, the more CO2 you generate. If you've got a strong response to the buildup of carbon dioxide, your breathing is going to be excessive. If your breathing is going to be excessive, you're going to cause fatigue to the breathing muscles, and you'll feel that you're more breathless than what you should be. We are doing this to train the body to cope to a higher pressure of carbon dioxide, because this is the gas that's being produced during physical exercise. We're going to train you directly to cope to higher amounts of this. Does that make sense? The two girls, you do your physical training, you really move your muscles, you're going to generate a lot of CO2. As your CO2 increases, your ventilation increases proportionately. So the CO2 in the blood isn't going to increase up by all that much. But we want to train the brain's reaction to the buildup of CO2. So really what it comes down to is, you put this into practice, your breathlessness during physical exercise reduces for the same given level of physical exercise.